Okay, today we are installing the 2 meter 144 to 148 megahertz, 440 to 450. So this should work very well. This is glass mount antenna. I had one of my Elmers told me that this is one of the easiest and most effective ways to quickly add an antenna to your car. And I'll give you a little secret as to how to keep it from falling off. It's easy. You don't have to drill any holes. It's actually effective. Ideally, you don't want to go through the glass like this. You don't want that disconnect there, but it will work absolutely fine, and I'll demonstrate that. So what we have here is some silicone. That's my thing on the right. That's something that doesn't come with system, but what you get with this is the inside of the antenna, and you get the cable, and you get the outside part. Now you can see I had to add an SMA connector here. This will go on my radio, my handheld handy talkie. So I chose my back left window here on the side of the car because I didn't want it to obstruct my vision on the other side, and I'm just going to put it right here on the side. Now this is an antenna that I installed a long time ago. It's a lot more expensive than this one, and it's been there using that silicone glue. It's been there for about 6 years. That comes with a little alcohol pad to make sure it's really clean. I'll let that dry. Now comes the secret that my Elmer taught me to keep this from falling off. I'm gonna put a nice bead all the way around it. Don't worry. This won't hurt much. This will keep water from entering inside of there and prying it apart. So this should make a really good seal and stay there forever. Of course, then I want to clean this up. What's really cool about this is that later, if you need to move this, all of the silicone will just kind of pry off. You can use a razor blade or a sharp edge and kind of dig it off, and it'll come right off. So I really like the silicone. It's waterproof sealant type stuff. It's really good for these kind of things. Clean the inside too. Now this piece goes on the inside, and all it has to do is attach to the other side, and you don't need to put any silicone here. And I think it doesn't matter what direction. I hope it doesn't. I'll find out. This little screw here is supposed to be an adjustment screw for SWR. It also comes with this ground plane. That's what they call it. It's not very long, but you're gonna have to adjust all these things. You're gonna have to adjust these things to get a low SWR. Do the best you can, you know, it's not going to be perfect. Okay, this also comes with it. It's plenty long, it's probably too long, in fact. So on first scan, I got 1.1 at 150 megahertz. Okay, so I was aiming for 146, and here's what I'm getting. . 1.32 at 145.8 megahertz. I spent about 10 minutes adjusting the screw, hitting scan, adjusting the screw, trying to hit 146. I decided to settle here, 1.31 at 145.5. It's just going to have to do. SMA. I got 4 mosquito bites making this video. I had to go out and get pants on because it was so bad. They just kept hitting me, and now they're getting my feet. I'm not kidding. Okay, so this is the grand test. Will it work?
When I transmitted. Anyway, let's...
November 9, Yankee Oscar, listening, testing. Now I've got an S meter of 9 right now. I'm down in a valley too, so I shouldn't be hitting. I'm not gonna talk to them, but I'm gonna try this. November 9, Yankee Oscar. No.
This is the WP0QXW repeater, St. Louis, Missouri. Your Echo Link station.
November 9, Yankee Oscar, testing, listening, new antenna. So I'm getting ready to go to Dayton and I wanted to get this up and running, and I think I did.